Hi everybody, we are very excited about the auction campaign. Karura won the first auction and became the first parachain of Kusama. More than 14,000 of participants contributed 500,000 of KSM. It's about 5% of all Kusama circulation, and its amazing and unexpected results show big interest for the Kusama ecosystem and DeFi on Kusama and Polkadot. We have a lot of auctions to come, but now we already have the leaders who will probably get the first free slots, and we will share our views. PromoTeam prepared an article, a definitive guide to Kusama Parachain auctions. If you want the details for all Parachain auction, you can see a link in the description below. Let's start with the first Parachain. Karura is an EVM-compatible DeFi platform that allows swapping, borrowing, lending, and staking liquidity. It will potentially become the backbone of all financial operations on Kusama because that's the place where people will be able to invest their money and trade with low fees. Since it will be the first mover in the ecosystem, most likely it will keep the dominant position for a long time. The platform has several modules. A trustless staking derivative, Liquid KSM. The underlying HOMA protocol allows users to join a special staking pool, stake their KSM tokens to gain staking yield, and get LKSM to stay liquid. These LKSM tokens can be used anywhere across all Kusama connected chains and can be redeemed anytime for KSM. They can even be used as collateral or as fee tokens. A stablecoin KUSD. It's based on the Hanzen protocol. It's very similar to Maker DAO and the way how it handles assets. Assets are locked in a CDP, collateralized debt positions, upon a user's request. After locking them, the protocol mints new KUSD tokens. An automatic risk management algorithm checks CDPs all the time to make sure that the value of the collateral is bigger than the value of minted KUSD. The protocol accepts many types of tokens, including almost all tokens of the Kusama ecosystem and even BTC and ETH via bridges. A DEX with an automated market maker. The Karura platform accepts any token as a fee, and that fee is very small compared to such giants as Uniswap, so we think that many users will move to it once it gets launched as a parachain. The native token for the platform is KAR. Its max supply is limited by the number of 100 million, and it's deflationary because all tokens received as fees for transactions, creating CDPs and penalties, are removed from the supply by burning them. The second top project that will probably win this second slot is Moonriver, Moonbeam for Polkadot. It's one of the most advanced Ethereum virtual machines and a smart contract platform. It can literally run contracts written for Ethereum with a minimum required amount of changes to the source code. The main features of Moonriver. Supports all Ethereum smart contracts written in Solidity and Viper. It's compatible with all Ethereum tools such as MetaMask, Truffle, and Remix. Supports Ethereum libraries such as Ethers.js, so any developer can work with a Moonriver node as if it was an Ethereum node. Also, it supports Web3 Python and JavaScript libraries, allowing to use IPC, HTTP, or WebSocket protocols the same way as Ethereum developers do. Cross-chain ERC20 token transactions. Moonriver can connect to Ethereum via the Kusama bridge and via Chain bridge and transfer tokens back and forth. Built-in integrations for oracles such as Chainlink, Razor Network, and Band protocol. At the same time, it's still a substrate-based blockchain, and it's fully compatible with the whole substrate toolset, including block explorers, front-end development libraries, and wallets. Moonriver is designed for several groups of developers. It can be used by Ethereum developers who want to migrate with their already existing projects to a more scalable and less expensive blockchain, or simply move a portion of their workload until Ethereum scales, which won't happen in the near future. Currently, Moonriver has second place in the crowd loan campaign, right after the Karura platform. we think that it will take the second slot because smart contracts are crucial for any large blockchain ecosystem, and finally enabling them will attract many developers to Kusama and then to Polkadot. The third leader of the Parachain campaign is scheiden, Plasm on Polkadot. Is basically the most advanced platform for building smart contracts on Kusama and a hub for dApps, which is unique in the way it rewards not only network validators, but also developers of popular dApps. It aims to incorporate a set of tools to use bridges between Kusama and Ethereum and to support all ETH layer 2 solutions in the future. Its main features supports both Ethereum virtual machine native to Ethereum and WebAssembly machine native to Substrate. One of its core features, the XVM cross virtual machine, creates a layer of abstraction that allows smart contracts to execute calls and read storage data from different contract engines, virtual machines, and languages within the same blockchain. Allows to write contracts in Solidity, Ink, Rust, C, C++, C#, TypeScript, Hex, and Kotlin. Natively supports MetaMask and Remix. 50% of its network fees go to reward developers of dApps. The more popular the dApp is, the more its developer gets. It's possible to change the dApp owner address in scheiden after deploying the contract. They will have an Ethereum bridge implemented in the near future. Optimistic virtual machine allowing dApp developers to use such layer 2 protocols as rollups. ZK rollups are fully supported right now. More protocols to come. Already has a cross-chain DEX quick swap running on top of scheiden. Scheiden and Plasm are going to be among the most useful parachains for Kusama and Polkadot respectively. They were funded by Binance, OKX, and many VCs. Even while some of their competitors support EVM, scheiden takes it to another level, being the all-in-one solution for any smart contracts related task. Incorporating multiple virtual machines, protocols, and allowing to use them simultaneously with its XVM, scheiden will definitely attract more developers creating cross-chain products. It may even connect to Ethereum as a layer 2 with all its L2 solutions ready to be used. Its native token is SDN and its max supply is 70 million. Its main purpose is governance and paying fees. Some of the holders of the original PL already got this one too from the lock drop, and now it's the chance to get some during the crowd loan action. The last two slots will be the battle of several projects. We will review them all in the next series. But until then, take care.